Hello, welcome to our channel LB Lectures. In today's class, we will see the derivation for deformation of solid truncated conical bar. So what is solid truncated conical bar? If the cross section is circle instead of rectangle, then we call it as solid truncated conical bar. Let us consider a truncated tapered conical bar. At this point, the diameter at section 1 is D1 and diameter at the section D2 be D2. So at any point, the cross-sectional area is a circle. Let the length be L, and here also let us consider a elemental length dx at a distance x from the section 1, and let the diameter of the element dx at a distance x be phi x. And since here also the area is constantly varying, you cannot use the deformation formula del is equal to PL by AE. And we know that the rate of change of length of the solid truncated conical bar for this length L k is equal to D2 minus D1 divided by L. So D2 minus D1 divided by L is the rate of change of length K. That is, larger diameter minus smaller diameter divided by L is equal to the rate of change of length, and it is denoted by the letter K. So now the diameter of this element phi x, which is at a distance of x from section 1, is equal to this D1 plus this rate of change of length into x. So this distance x. So the rate of change of length is D2 minus D1 divided by L into x. So the diameter of this element dx at a distance of x from section 1 is equal to D1 plus D2 minus D1 divided by L into x. So which you can write it as phi x is equal to D1 plus kx. So this is the diameter of this element dx, which is at a distance of x from the section 1. And if you see here, on the either end, the solid truncated conical bar is subjected to axial tensile load. So because of this axial tensile load P, which is acting on the either side, this elemental length dx will be subjected to change in length or deformation. So the deformation of this elemental length dx, LL, we know that P into the length is dx divided by area of this elemental length AX into E. And since the cross section is the circle, since this area of this element AX can be written as pi by 4 pi x square, which is pi x is the diameter, pi by 4 pi x square. So P dx divided by pi by 4 pi x square into E. And we know that this phi x is nothing but d1 plus kx. So substitute phi x equal to d1 plus kx here, you'll be getting change in length of this element del L del is equal to 4p dx divided by pi d1 plus kx whole square into e. So this 4 has gone into the numerator, and instead of this phi x, you have substituted d1 plus kx. So this is the deformation of the element dx. And now for to get the total deformation of the bar because of this axial load P, integrate this equation for the given boundary 0 to L. So the initial condition is 0, the final condition is L. So integrate this elemental deformation for the total boundary 0 to L. So limit is, initial limit is 0, final limit is L. This is del. So we know that elemental deformation is 4p dx divided by pi e d1 plus kx whole square. And if you are taking this constant 4p by pi e outside, you will be getting 0 to L d1 plus kx minus to the power of minus 2 into dx. And if you see here, it is in the form of integral 1 by x square. If it is coming to the denominator, means it will be in the form of 1 by x square. And what is the integral of 1 by x square? we all know that it is minus 1 by x. And now performing this integration, we will get minus 1 by d1 plus kx. And don't forget to divide with the coefficient of x. And here the coefficient of x is k, and you have to divide by 1 by k. And now for this term, you need to apply the limit 0 to L. And we know that this rate of change of length k is equal to d2 minus d1 by L. So substitute k is equal to d2 minus d1 by L here instead of this k. So you will be getting minus 4p by pi ek within the bracket 1 by d1 plus, instead of this k, substitute this d2 minus d1 divided by L into x, and the limits are from 0 to L. And if you are applying this upper limit, so instead of this x, it will be L. So this L and L will be getting cancels. This plus d1 and this minus d1 will be getting cancelled. So here you will be getting 1 by d2 when you are substituting the upper limit. And similarly, when you are substituting this lower limit, instead of this x, it will be 0. It will be 1 by d1. So here you will be getting minus 1 by d1. Since you are substituting the lower limit, it is minus 1 by d1. Upon simplifying this equation, you will be getting total deformation of the bar del is equal to 4PL divided by pi into E into D1 into D2. So where E is the Young's modulus of the material, P is the applied axial tensile load, L is the length of the bar, D1, D2 are the diameters at the section 1 and section 2. And if you see here, if this cross-sectional area would have been constant. So this, if this cross-sectional area would have been constant, this d1 will be equal to d2 is equal to d. So here it will, this d1, d2 can be replaced by d square. And if you are bringing this 4 to the denominator, means pi by 4 d square. So pi by 4 d square is nothing but area. So you will be getting the equation deformation equal to PL by AE. So like that, you can check your deformation equation for this solid truncated conical bar for remembering it. So thanks for watching our channel LB Lectures. Please like, comment, share and subscribe for further updates.